Hi, welcome to Hotchkiss Games. Last time we climbed all that stuff, and we were terrible at jumping. So bad. Hopefully there's no more jumping, or if there is, it's easy. Or at least we succeed at it. Please let us succeed at it. I would assume we're trying to make our way back to the castle and find Yorda, which probably means we're gonna find her mom. Ooh, goodness, this is epic scenery. This reminds me very much of the first level of God of War when you were trying to fight the, Kraken on the boat. Wow, this looks treacherous. Oh, goodness. Okay, first jump of the episode. Wow, massive jump. I didn't know we had that in us. Jump up. Goodness. I feel like we're getting pretty close to the end of this game. I don't know for sure, seeing as this is my first time playing it, but I feel like there's not much left to do besides rescue Yorda from her mother. Unless they throw in some arbitrary thing in between this and that. Which they very well could. And, okay. I didn't know if I was supposed to, like, jump backwards or not. Oh, piss. Oof. Almost failed right there. Luckily, we have not yet failed. Alright, getting on some pipes. And drop down. And where are we actually going? I think we're going back to the castle, and apparently we're entering through the sewer system, by the looks of it. Oh, goodness. Maybe jumping is not a good idea on these pipes, because I almost fell off yet again. And also, since we don't have Yorda to save, I don't really know where they'd send us back to if we did in fact fall. So I don't want to think about that. Okay. We are out of the rain, thankfully. And I'm just in a cave with some pipes. That's how Peanut does. He's just being him. You be you, Peanut. You be you. Okay. We are in a very tall, cylindrical room that I'll need to go down. Or I could go this way. But I'm probably going to use the chain. Chain? Do I need to... Yes. I'm going to need to swing. Good old air thrusting always makes the episode more lively. Air thrust, and that's probably good enough. Yes. Cool. Gonna go this way. I'm assuming... Oh, piss. Don't fall. Let's go this way, Peanut. Peanut. Oh, goodness. I'm assuming we have to make our way to the bottom, arbitrarily choosing the right path, and I was mistaken. Logically, and from experience, choosing the left path. So far, success. Obstacle, success. Jump up. Get up. What do we got here? We got a thing. I don't really know what this is. A minecart of some sort? Oh, it's a chain. Okay, yeah. How best do we use that chain? Are we supposed to fall down? I don't know. The camera kind of looks like it wants me to fall. But let's go over this way. Okay, no. What if I fell in this crack? What if I just jumped for the chain? That seems like the actual smart thing to do, right? Peanut. Oh my goodness. We almost died right there. I did not think he was going to grab that in time. Now, do we have to, like, swing and then hit the wall and then hope we can get to that ladder? No, there's a ledge right there. Cool. That ladder looks kind of pointless. That way is broken. Let's go to the left. What is that? That's just a rock. We have mounted that. If that was Everest, we would have become... that's a stupid thing to say. Clearly not Everest. But this game is my Everest. My goodness. It has been quite the experience and quite the healthy challenge. That way... looks like I can go pretty far, but also looks like it's kind of pointless to go that way, so let's just go down this ladder. And fall. Am I gonna die here? Oh, do. Can I make this jump? Whew. Goodness, the jumps are getting scarier and scarier in this game. I don't see anything that way. There's a ladder right here, and yeah, let's just take it. Oh, there are yorta blocks right here. Huh. I wonder if there's a way to activate them without yorta. Or if we... do we get yorta back sometime soon and are able to activate those? I don't know. Let's go this way. What do we got? We have a boat. Can I, like, use this boat? I feel like this is the boat that was in that beginning cutscene we saw at the very beginning of the scene. Of this game, rather. What do I do? What do I do? Can I climb this thing? It kind of looks like I can grab onto that ledge right there. No? Ledge. Grab onto the ledge. Okay, no. I can't do anything with the boat. I can get in the boat. Am I supposed to just, like, swim for it? No, because there's a ledge up here. What am I doing? How did I miss that? Honestly. I was about to swim, and that would have been a little embarrassing. Goodness gracious. All right. What is this? Oh my goodness. It is a magic sword. I'm so excited. We are now badasses. This can probably activate the order block. Because at the very beginning of the game, when we got locked up, someone was able to activate those with a sword just like this. Holy crap, I've been wanting an upgraded sword ever since I saw how common the sword we got was. This is super freaking exciting. Whew. Did I just hit him? That is awesome. I've earned a trophy, Royal Arms. That's probably from getting this sword. Awesome. Just hit this. It kind of looks like we're going back to the, I don't know, what to call it? Like the prison chamber? The place we were first locked up at? We have a freaking lightning sword. We are such badasses. This is essentially a chidori, by the way. And... yes! This is, in fact, the first room we've ever been in, and there are bad guys. They are definitely gonna, like, be one-hit KO'd with this chidori sword. We have a freaking lightning blade. Come here, little bad guys. Wait, where'd they go? Oh, there they are. Is there anything I should do before going up there? I don't think so. Oh, humble beginnings. We were once locked up in this cage. That happened like 7 hours ago. In game time. Let's freaking get our sweet revenge. Oh, hey, there's Yorta. And those guys have horns. They're like me. but made out of smoke and kind of evil and will soon be dead. Check out my lightning blade. Holy piss. It is a one-hit KO. This is awesome. I wonder why Yorta wasn't chained up in the birdcage yet again. Like, why is she just randomly in the center of this room? Is there one more guy? Is there one more guy? I think we're good. Well, hey, babe. Nope. Okay. Our reunion's gonna have to wait a minute. Wait, these things are lighting up. Are they coming out? I think they're coming out of these little prison cell sarcophagus things. I mean, for once in her life, Yorta doesn't seem to be in danger, so I guess I can go hunting after these guys a little bit. This is like is this the final boss battle? Surely not. I'm like 90% confident that we're gonna have to face Yorta's mother at some point. Dude, seriously, like, get down here. Oh, there's another one. Man, they just keep coming. This is literally, like, every one of these little prison cell things is becoming, like, a guy, it looks like. How far we've come that it used to take us 6 hits with the struggle stick to kill these guys. And now with our Chidori blade, it's literally taking 1 hit. Ugh, that's so cool. Thank goodness for that. I am interested to know why this sword was just down in the sewer, basement, dock, harbor, place like that. And it also has this chain dangling from it. I don't know if you can see it. There it is. So it kind of looks like it was chained there. Or kind of like the forgotten legendary blade. I don't really know. I wonder if this is the Queen's blade. That'd be interesting. Though, that guy at the beginning did have it. Or at least have one very similar, so it's probably not that special. I mean, it's still a magic sword, so it's still pretty dang special. But I'm just rambling, because this fight is literally taking longer than any one of these smog fights has ever taken. Easily the longest one. Clearly they have to, I guess, show me how powerful my sword is before I go up against Yorta's mom, who will probably be much harder, but still. I'm pretty well convinced, guys. You've convinced me. The sword's pretty powerful. Can we stop with this already? Can we stop? I've learned my lesson. I realize my power. You know what? I will responsibly handle this blade. Because I'm a Boy Scout. Oh, goodness. Yorta, can we, like, get up and do something? No, you're just stuck on the pedestal. Da-da-da-da-da. Swinging my blade through the shadows. Cutting the smog like butter. There's nothing to do but wallow. I'm hoping this game gets better. I'm ready for a new fight. Bring on Yorta's mother. I'm gonna slay her with my Chidori blade. Yep. This is the first time that we've really had an extended amount of music, which is pretty cool. It's, I don't know, kind of creepy organ music, so it could be better. But hey, it's the first time they've felt like added ambiance in an auditory way, which is pretty cool. But honestly, like, most of these are lit up now. But there's still a piss load of them. I want to say we're almost done, but I mean, that's more of a hope than a knowledge of any sort. Hey, guys. Let me slice you with my blade. Let me kill you where you lay. It does not work to fight these guys out in the open because they just run away. I really do need to be in a tight, confined space like this. Come at me, bro. Keep calm and battle on. I'm a little Viking boy. I have a cape and a lightning blade. You don't want to mess with this guy. Screw off, ghosts. Seriously, come on. Come here. Where are you going? Stop being so fidgety. I mean, I realize you've just seen me kill like 40 of your friends, but that may not happen to you. You should have more courage than that, man. Nope. Nope, you died too. Okay. Most of these are lit up besides that one. Does that mean there's still one guy left? Nope, cutscene. It's like a Christmas tree of death. And it looks like we can finally move on. Yorda, I kind of hate to admit it, but I've missed you. Can you come with me? It doesn't look like it. Well, that's too bad. Don't worry, Yorda, though. I'm going to take care of this. Your mom's not a nice lady. Let's go! Ooh, goodness, this could be it. We are climbing the tower. Where are we? We're in the throne room. And that's a very intimidating throne. Well, let's do this. Okay. Let's be honest. We all thought there was going to be a cutscene when I got up to the throne. Right? Should I just climb some stuff and Yoda's mother? Where are you? Can you get out here? I've got this sword. It tastes like cotton candy. Oh, piss. Now she's here. Final showdown. Final destiny, Fox only. No items. Do I just run at her? Let's do it. Okay, another cutscene. Why not just run those cutscenes together? Honestly.
What did you do to her?
Silence, boy. You're too late. Oh. I thought that was her speaking. My body has become too old and won't last much longer, but Yorda is going to grant me the power to be resurrected. To be my spiritual vessel is the fulfillment of her destiny. She's like Mordred. The next time her body wakes, Yorda will be no more. Now put down the sword and leave. This is what she would want you to do. Don't listen to her, Peanut. We hate this woman. Find your resolve. Find your courage. Oh, piss. What was that nonsense? You're a nuisance, boy. Do you want to die that much? She has a bubble around her. Feel like I need this. Epic final boss. Oh, piss not. What the piss is that? Oh, cool. So my magic sword protects me against that. This looks helpful. Let's stand right here. What you gonna do, bad girl? Yeah. probably not going to help to just attack this thing. Wait, where's my sword? Piss. I'm going to die now. Oh, no, 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 no. Wait, I didn't die. That seems like a glitch. Where's my sword? Where's my sword? Now I died. Oh, it was right over there. Oh, goodness. Glitches. Yeah. There's no way I'm listening to this cutscene again. Grab my sword. And go fight this lady. Come on, Yoda's mother, you're gonna die. I'm at least gonna burst your bubble. Now I have to remember where my sword went. Okay, it's right there. I'm gonna let her do her thing, and then I'm gonna go. Okay. Sword, come to me. Whew. Attack again. And now I went to the other side. I'm gonna get behind this thing. Get behind it. Where's my sword at? Here it is. It's really difficult to see where it goes. You can only kind of see the general direction. And then you're just gonna have to guess. Okay, it went off this way again. Get behind the pillar. Get behind the pillar. Okay, my sword's right over there. And go. So this seems pretty easy. Oh, goodness. I only barely made that, though. I did not see where my sword went. Okay, it's right there. Is it stuck in the freaking wall? No. It just was kind of glitchy right there. Well, if this is... I hope this is only part one of this battle, because this is not all that interesting or difficult. I did die on it, and... Oh, piss, 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 piss. Get behind the pillar. My sword... I don't know where my sword is. Excuse me, have you seen a lightning blade? It's called a Chidori. I need to use it to kill you, but I can't find it. Literally, where is my freaking sword? How do you lose a lightning blade in a freaking dark and dank dungeon? Oh, piss. It's all the way back there. How am I supposed to get to that? There's got to be other things I can use as protection, because literally nothing else. I don't think I can make this, guys. Guess I'll just go right here and freaking run for my life. Oh, that seemed like a glitch. I don't think I made that in time. I don't need to stand behind this pillar, but I will because it's faster. Hey, her bubble's gone. This may be it. Die, Yoda's mom. Holy shit. That was dramatic. Yoda will never be able to escape this castle. Sounds like she's saying, Krakoja, even if you take my life. Oh, my horns broke. And there's blood coming out of them. What? Hey, Yoda. I killed your mom. Hope you don't mind. Oh, goodness. Is she, like, getting recharged? Or killed? It looks like she's becoming goop. Are you still the girl that I know? Is Peanut dead? Oh goodness, the castle's falling. This is kind of reminding me of Mystique right now. Clearly Mystique's not like a dark energy matter, but she's blue and she walks around naked. Oh, look at that. Yorta really does want to help us. That's cool. Can you pick up my lightning blade on the way out, please? No? And the bridge crumbles. Actually, kind of everything's crumbling. I hope Yorta's mom had homeowner's insurance. Okay. I hope you have a plan for getting us out, because stuff's kind of falling apart. The elevator still works, though. Look at that fine, dark Viking engineering. I don't know what to call it. Oh, the boat. From whence we came, huh? Wait, you're not getting in, Yorta? But... you don't want to leave this castle? Is this goodbye? Well, thank you, Yorta. Huh. The castle falls to ruin. It's actually really interesting to watch the places that we've run through, solving puzzles and becoming closer to Yorta, fall apart like this. And the end credits are rolling. Wow. I don't really know what to say about this game. It was quite the journey. And now that I'm at the end of it, that was very, very satisfying. A very unconventional game. There was only one big boss battle, but even though it was easy, and even though it wasn't, didn't seem all that exceptional, it was very rewarding in the end. Cameo appearance from the Struggle Stick, only appropriate as we end things off. Wow. Even though we never really saw Yorta talk, I could never understand what she said. There really is something about that character. She was really well developed through just motion alone, really. Just when you carry something around with you throughout an entire game, throughout an entire adventure or experience, it gains a certain momentum, meaning, perhaps. Yorta's special because she went through this entire adventure with us. She didn't need to talk. She didn't need to climb down ladders faster or use her electric powers for anything special other than Yorta blocks. It was enough that she was just there. Now I wonder what's to become of Peanut, our lone little Viking Superman adventurer. I mean, at the end, at that final boss battle, we saw that his horns had broken. And I think we figured out throughout this game that it's really his horns that had neglected him from his society. It's really his horns that had thrown him into this castle in the first place to be sacrificed or just removed from society for whatever reason. Now that his horns are gone, does that mean he will be able to re-enter society? Has what appeared to be a struggle or a challenge in life really gone to give him hope for a life where he will not be subject to prejudice? People who have horns are people too. Obviously, I recognize that this game has had a cliffhanger ending, and I can't tell you whether or not Yorta survived. But I hope she did. Goodbye, Yorta. This has been an experience. And Peanut lives. Hornless, yes, but no longer hopeless, I think. Still kind of derpy, though. Wouldn't be Peanut without that. Am I still playing? Wow, I am. I thought this game was done. What exactly is there to see in this place? I've got to say, this coda ending is surprising, but I'm not sure what the point of it is. Everything is blindingly light. Is there actually an end to this journey? Or can I keep running forever? I'm probably gonna give this like another minute. And then give it up as a symbol. Give it up as a moral. Yorta. Wow. I'm glad they included that. Emancipation. Well, thank you all for tuning in to Hotchkiss Games Plays ICO. That was a really rewarding experience. And I don't think I ever showed this, but yes, this is the bizarre little song that plays every time you save. Thanks for watching, guys.